Hey guys, Eddie the Magic Monk here. Last lesson, we ran a query for creating a table. So if you didn't follow our instructions in the last lesson, this is basically what we did. We created a table called students with integer primary key, student ID, last name, first name, address, phone number, print balance, and so on. Now, what I want you guys to do before we create another query is to save this query, because if you don't save it, then it just goes away. So just click Control S to save, and let's call it Create Student Table Query. Right, save it. And now you can close the query. And on the left-hand side, if you go to Queries, you'll be able to find the query to. Don't run it. If you right click design view, open it up again, and then you can run it again if you want, but we've already created the table. So let's go back to just do all access objects and you'll be able to see everything. So now that we have a table, if we open up the table, we can insert values by just typing things in here. So for example, I might create a student called student ID 1, even though that's probably gonna be in the thousands if you have a big school. Last name, just Smith, first name, John, address, 230 Sunny Street, blah, blah, blah. Phone number. Just a random phone number. Sorry if that's really a number. Print balance 20.43 or something. Doesn't matter. Okay, so we've just inserted a record into this table or a row into this table. So now I'm going to take you through how to use SQL to do that. So let's create another query. So go to Create, Query Design. Close this show table window and go to SQL view. And now I'm going to show you how to do an insert query. So let's put in the SQL insert into students because that's the name of our table. And let's put in values. Okay, so what values do we want to insert? The first one is an ID, so let's put ID is 2. Let's put in what else? We got the last name is White. First name, let's put in Daniel. Address 6. Indro Road. I'm just making all this up. And then what else do I have? Phone number is 0. All right, just making things up. And then print balance. Let's put in. What do I want to put in? 30.24. Okay, close it off. And yeah, you should be able to actually, let's put a semicolon here. Okay, now if I want to run this, go into the design tab, click run, and it should insert this row. So click run. You're about to append one row, click yes, and you can see in the table, you might have to close it and open it up again. You got the new row inserted. So yeah, that's the query for inserting records. If you want, you can go back to this query and just put 3 and put someone else's name in. So let's put Lee. Let's put Brian 7 something Mars Road 09 blah 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 10. Okay. Run it again, design run, yes, and you got another row. Now you will only see the changes if you close the table and open it up again. And you can see we've added another student into our table. So already we can see some problems. For example, in the phone number field, we got some numbers that have the wrong digits. We got the zero got stripped off. So yeah, all these are things that we don't need. So let's talk about how to fix that in our next tutorial. Thanks for watching. See you next time.